Welcome back to Washing Nation at 9 with me, Gauri Dwivedi. Despite the odds stacked against him, Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Kamal Nath is putting a brave front, claiming he still has the numbers. He said there is no threat to his government and that he will be able to prove his majority and his government will complete its five-year term. The BJP, meanwhile, has got a prized catch from the Congress's camp, which is Jyotiraditya Sindhya, a man very close to the Gandhis, part of Rahul Gandhi's inner circle, was a second generation Sindhia into the Congress party. Remember, he joined the party after his father's untimely demise in 2001 and has been a member of parliament from Guna since then. He lost out in 2019, was wanting a Rajya Sabha membership, but the party did not allow so. And that seemed to have triggered his exit, followed by resignations galore, even as all MLAs are now holed up in different parts of the country. BJP's MLAs are in Gurugram, Congress MLAs are in Jaipur, while the rebel or the baghi MLAs have been holed up and having, well, quite a fun-filled life the last 48 hours in Bengaluru, with resort politics in full display. The question that we are asking is, who has the numbers? And what do they look right now? And what will be the discretion of the speaker and the governor? That's really the key question here, as things still look very fluid. Let's first listen in to what Kamal Nath had to say the last time he spoke on whether or not his government is safe. We come back and ask the big question. Shivam Chhabra, Atikur Rahman, Subit Peer, Manish Pandey, Choita Basu continue to be with us. Okay, let's ask this question to the two to the BJP spokesperson first. Shivam, what do the numbers look like right now? Kamal Nath is still very confident that he will not be able to topple his government.
Hello, congratulations to him. I don't have to say much about it, but I think let's see how the things work out, because I honestly speaking, I am not too in a position to probably tell what all is happening, but certainly not in favor of Kamal Nath ji, that is what I can say.
Okay, let's pull up that graphic as to how the numbers look like. Remember, 230 is the strength of the House, two MLAs are no more, and that has brought the House down to 228, and there have been these many resignations on your screen, 22, that has brought down the majority mark because the strength of the House has reduced. Now, there's just one thing I want to tell our viewers, that the anti-defection law kicks in, which is why the MLAs have resigned, because they were not one-third, because that is when there is no resignation needed, because they can just walk off as a large enough group and merge with another, which hasn't happened. It's not obviously one-third, as you can see the numbers looking right now. So then are we to believe, Manish, that BJP is comfortably home, or are those back channel talks that Kamal Nath has been having? Remember, there are reports suggesting that he is in touch with 10 or 12 of those rebel MLAs and is offering everything and the moon. So that may have also led him to be confident.
Gauri, I think he is just keeping the spirits high of his partymen, but as I see now, things are pretty much in control, and if you see the day's development, you know what, all those MLAs who have gone with Jyotiraditya Sindhya and they have rebelled, what were the first message? The party didn't even waste a minute or an hour in giving Jyotiraditya the first thing which he wanted, or the first thing for which he had to leave a party of 19 years. his cradle of politics, Congress. And he was supposed to be the close buddy and the pal along with Sachin Pilot, Dipinder Hooda, and all these Jitin Prasad, and all these people who have gone with Rahul Gandhi. But leaving that party, and he immediately got the RS berth, which will send a strong signal to his followers and also to many more. That look, the party has not treated him in a non-serious manner. They are taking him seriously.
Hmm.
So, and what I have been telling since morning, that who is actually in the driver's seat or having the main remote control.
Hmm.
Mr. PM Modi himself
hmm.
is monitoring the situation. The entire BJP machinery, from the central leadership to the state leadership, they are all, and there is no discord for the first time. It's not that there are not camps within BJP in the state or from center to the state.
There are several.
So everyone from Kailash Vijayawargiya to Narendra Singh Tomar to Sahasbuddhe to Shivraj Chauhan himself, they all are working in perfect combination and trying to ensure that this time, because this is just the beginning of what BJP is trying, which I just want to just hint that there is more to come after Jyotiraditya Scindia.
Okay.
Maybe a young vote, young faces from this party, which is not delivering on the aspirations and the desire of these
okay,
the youth
brigade. So I'll tell you what, you know, the name that Manish Pandey is referring to is essentially Sachin Pilot.
Right.
But, you know, Sachin Pilot has also given a soundbite, and he said that he's, unhappy, and it's very unfortunate that Scindia left, and he said that, hopefully things could have been resolved collaboratively instead of how they have reached the breaking point or the tipping point. Remains to be seen whether Sachin Pilot would follow suit or not. But that's the larger question here, Shivam. I come back to you that Kamal Nath asked for a mass resignation of all his cabinet ministers to ensure that, you know, the rebel MLAs are accommodated. Then there are reports suggesting that the MLAs were only wanting to extend support for Rajya Sabha and were not really wanting to jump ship from Congress to BJP. And then 12 of them are in contact with Kamal Nath right now. So things are still not as simple for the BJP as many would want us to believe.
See, Gauri, what all questions you're posing it to me should be posed to the Congress spokesperson. What all is happening in the camp of Congress party. What are you talking about?
No, but it impacts the BJP.
Is the Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh.
No, it impacts the BJP,
the
sir.
Party who seeks resignation.
It impacts the BJP,
but,
sir.
No,
it impacts
but
the BJP very, very directly.
What all impacts the BJP is we are keeping a close tap on the situation, Gauri. But what all we can presume and perceive out of the situation is that there is huge unrest in the leadership of Kamal Nath ji in Madhya Pradesh. And I think there is no doubt about that. Jyotiraditya Scindia ji coming over to the BJP, I mean a person who's been in the Congress party for about 19 years. His father was in Congress party, was stalwart in Congress party for so many years. Ultimately he felt bad and probably felt sad. I probably fell out with the Congress party, then something is certainly wrong with the leadership of Congress party. Na? So we must understand, we are keeping a close tap on the situation. Let's see how these things work out.
Okay.
But I think more answers to be posed to the Congress spokesperson, so that they have to do the more answering than the BJP side, I would say.
Okay. Atikur Rahman, you want to come in there on what's happening as far as Madhya Pradesh is concerned?
Well, Gauri, see, I look towards these things from the perspective of being a lecturer in public administration. For me, what matters is the governance, you know. Now, whatever Kamal Nath might have done with Mr. Scindia, and things went wrong. Now, whatever formation the government of MP takes place, herein what I look towards is the inclusion of non-Hindutva faces in the BJP. You know, after the demise of Mr. Arun Jaitley and Sushma Swaraj ji.
So the moderate face of BJP, that's what you're saying.
The
moderate face of the BJP.
Face.
The moderate face of the BJP.
Exactly. The non-Hindutva ones.
Mm.
So if more people are, you know, entrusted responsibility and they take the BJP towards an absolute governance point of view. You know, like, you know, when there was a shift in Maharashtra, I pointed out to people that the Shiv Sena always, besides the Hindutva phase, they are also having a governance phase, which are liked by the people.
Okay.
Be they towards the Ram Mandir, we don't mind. We all hope for a great Ram Mandir in Ayodhya.
Then, you know, which brings me to ask the question, sir, that if Sindhya is such an asset to the BJP, obviously he was an asset for the Congress as well. How come the central leadership did not wake up to the possibility of him exiting and adding, to BJP's armor?
Gauri, was that to me?
Yes, sir.
Well, now see, the things, you know, perhaps, you know, Mr. Sindhya have a background, you know, with the Sangh and with the BJP. You know, his father was, of course, a very, very dominant figure in the Congress party. But the grandmother, even the aunts, they have a background towards that. And besides, you know, look at the things which change. Mr. Sindhya was hoping for a better sense prevails with Mr. Kamal Nath.
Mm.
Initially also he warned the party. Mm. You know, when there was a senior person being selected even in Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh.
Yes.
So he was waiting for the opportunity. He must have, you know, let known his, you know, intention to Sonia Gandhi and even Rahul Gandhi. So, it depends, you know, how people are treated within the parties.
Okay, that makes all the difference. Even as the larger question that we are asking, Jyota, let me come to you, then I get in Sumit as well, which is that it almost looks like a mystery as to who really has the numbers, because there have been all sorts of reports coming in. Rebel MLA saying that, you know, videos coming in that they were okay with Raj Sabha, but they are not okay with jumping ship from the Congress to the BJP, which makes us wonder where really do the numbers lie.
So, you see, this is getting a little confusing. And but before that, I just want to mention a small point. The gentleman before me who talked about, you know, Hindutva versus governance, it is not Hindutva versus governance, it does not work like that. To say that, you know, people who follow Hindutva do not know how to govern, I mean, that is outrageous. That's an outrageous even to think of something like that. So, and for that matter,
Hindutva,
in fact,
Hindutva undermines governance, ma'am.
No, no,
Hindutva,
please.
Hindutva undermines governance.
I don't think you, I mean, frankly, let us not get into that, because you see, that is kind of your out, I mean, kind of out, I mean, you are undermining a whole thought process which has some legitimacy. You may not be following it, so others may not be following it, but there are people who follow that, okay? But to say that they are all incompetent is very, very, I mean, simplifying matters. So let us not get into that territory. Having said
because
that, now
that is an antithesis of the constitution's secular fabric.
What you want me to get into that secular fabric? The word that was illegally introduced into the constitution? What secularism are you talking about? That was under emergency, 1976.
Look, Gauri, a constitution's basic ideal becomes, you know.
So I mean, but here we are not talking about that.
Okay,
here we are not talking about
issue,
that.
You know?
Here we are not
okay,
talking
you know,
ideology.
Let's not talk about something, you know, that could potentially derail the entire topic.
Exactly.
The larger issue is Jyotiraditya Sindhya. He was okay with the secular ideology of Congress party till
and
2 days back,
okay,
and now
he's
okay with the ideology of BJP. So let's be very clear as to what, you know, Mr. Sindhya is also expecting out of this entire process, which is a clear quid pro quo in exchange for what he has done. The
exactly.
question, Jyota, I was asking you is that
yes.
where do the numbers lie? Then
yeah.
I get in Manish. Yes.
You see, this is where I would like to, I mean, I hope the BJP has got its kind of numbers in order. Because you see, it should not, the kind of experience it had in Maharashtra, if it something similar gets repeated, it will land with egg on its face.
Hmm.
And this is something, this is going to be bad for the party, it is bad optics, it is a bad, it's not good for the morale of their party cadre. So let us hope BJP has got its own house in order in terms of, you know, how to handle this particular these MLAs, because these MLAs,
and that's something MLAs, that one learned from the Karnataka mess, by the way. You know, the rebel MLAs had to be accommodated, not everybody got a ticket, then there was enough and more of heartburns. It was not easy for Yeddurappa to also placate all of them, so there's enough and more. Yes,
and think of what happened in Maharashtra. Maharashtra, you know, all those MLAs that Ajit Pawar had promised, okay, he apparently paraded them in front of the governor. Where did they go? They all vanished. You see, so let us hope BJP has learned its lessons, that BJP is not jumping the gun.
Shivam Chhabra, I'll have to give you a chance to counter, then I get in Manish and Sumit. Yes. Respond to what Joyita is saying.
I would say that I think the situation is...
She is essentially saying all that glitters is not gold.
But the point is...
Exactly.
That's what Joyita is saying.
Yeah, exactly.
See, we are keeping a close tab on this division. Let us just wait for the right moment to let me reply the right thing to you. I don't want to probably present you with the uncooked food. I'll certainly give you a good meal out of it.
Okay. Okay. All right. So you know, Manish, the larger issue that we are talking about is that, you know, what is the reason for Kamal Nath to be so confident? Are there still back channel communications that are currently on? Because, you know, he did ask his entire cabinet to resign. He is still willing to offer them everything, that the BJP may or may not be in a position to do so, because not all of them will be given tickets. Not all of them can be accommodated as ministers, just like we learned from the Karnataka model.
Gauri, this is the biggest political slugfest after the national level politics we are seeing in the states. And you have a master manipulator, as we call him, of Congress politics, because he was the manager of the Congress politics so far. He was actually, when other than the UD ministry, he was more in the parliamentary affairs, and then also he was handling most of the important portfolios in Congress. So with his experience and the way he handled things, but one thing you should not, as Mr. Chhabra is not elaborating what is going on behind, but the thing is that he is pitted against a united BJP. And united BJP in Madhya Pradesh matters a lot than the divided Congress in Madhya Pradesh. Now, coming to the other point, which I'm just getting very desperate to talk to my professor friend. My professor friend, are you listening? Hello?
Yes, yeah.
My professor friend.
Yes, I'm listening, sir.
Secularism for me is not that I abuse my religion and pay respect to others.
Exactly.
Okay? Being a Hindu, I'm also the founder member of India Islamic Culture Center. And yesterday I called two Muslim friends, families to my house to celebrate Holi. And I go on Eid to their house. So don't bring in religion into governance. That way, you are actually undermining the democracy which has voted this government to power with such a mandate, which is unprecedented. And let me tell you, if you are a professor of public policy, I've also taught Indian history. An entire country has faced the ancient dharma, which is still the core of the governance. No one has questioned that. Even the British has not, they have failed to question that.
All right, okay. You know, we've
so don't bring
we've
in these things into don't bring these things into
we've digressed
such
completely.
A platform like
okay.
MuseX.
So I'll tell you what. These are larger issues.
But
the fact of the matter, as I said, Mr. Sindhia's calculations were very clear, simple, and based on a roadmap that was promised to him. I don't think he got into any of the larger cerebral discussions that we are having, but Mr. Rehman deserves a chance to counter. Let's get in.
Sir, I distinguish between Hinduism and Hindutva, and I am not mixing religion with politics or administration. What I meant was, for me, it's governance more important than Hindutva.
Unfortunately, you don't even know
what Hinduism is. If Hinduism becomes...
Listen.
Which is bad, which is the antithesis of our secular credentials.
Professor, sir,
what is secularism?
Professor, sir, listen. If Hinduism becomes protective about their own, and if they become slightly aggressive, you call Hindutva...
Ask him, what is Hindutva? He is making allegations against Hindutva.
Sir, you
should know about Hindutva.
And what do you say that Hindutva linked to governance, the entire
you
government,
give good
then you are casting aspersions, then you are casting...
You give the basic necessities, ensure basic necessities.
What?
That's all, nothing else.
Were the minority issues not taken care of? What was triple talaq all about? Tell me.
Nothing. Triple talaq was just a hoax by the government. They hijacked the issue.
And that's why the young ladies voted to Modi.
What about the allocation for education for minorities?
Come on,
I think
let's
be pretty
frank,
high under
we
this
discuss,
government.
We discuss
and that's
at
the
least
duty of the government. That's the duty of the government. Now you are bringing religion into politics.
I'm not bringing religion. I'm only
okay. All right. You know what? I'll have to come in there because, frankly, as
with
I said,
to you,
no, sir, no, Shivam, I'll have to come in there. I'm sorry, I'm not going to allow this
professor
any further. Shivam Chopra, I'll have to come in there. I'm not going to allow this any further. For another time, another day, we're going to have that discussion. As I said, Mr. Sindhya was perfectly fine with the secular fabric
absolutely
of Congress, and he's now perfectly fine with how the BJP is, and which it did not find secular 2 days back, but it is secular enough for Sindhya right now. So, as I said, definitions evolve according to which side of the table you sit on, which side of the debate you are really on. As I said, Mr. Sindhya's discussions and calculations were very clear, and that's the larger question here. But you know, as you know, Sumit, we are talking about what happens as far as Madhya Pradesh is concerned. It's going to be the role of the speaker and the role of the governor that will also be very interesting. And at this stage, the governor has no plans of coming back and rushing to Madhya Pradesh. He is not in MP right now.
No, you absolutely got it right, because what we saw in Karnataka, especially the role of speaker, he can kind of, you know, suspend these MLAs. He can allow them to vote or he cannot allow them to vote. Depends on how do the numbers really shape up, because we know he's a Kamal Nath loyalist, and how are the numbers tilting for or in favor of Kamal Nath, he can really do that. But beyond that, then ARCA and governor has to intervene, so it can go to a Supreme Court. But beyond after some technicalities and all, it will ultimately come to voting.
So the role of the speaker will be extremely important,
will be,
it, more it than can, the governor,
it
will
can,
be the speaker.
It can delay for sure, it can cause delay, it can cause hurdles, you can call a session, you cannot call a session. There are a lot of things which are in your discretion, because a lot of things in a speaker are in his discretion, which are not in the rule book.
Okay, so more updates coming in as far as those rebel MLAs are concerned. As I said, reports have been coming in through the day about how many of them have quit, only assuming Rajya Sabha was the premise, and how many of them were actually willing to jump ship. The number was lower in the morning. It has risen since then, because video messages have been coming in thick and fast of all these MLAs. Seven more rebel MLAs have released their message. It was about 9 or 10 in the morning. It now is at 17. That's what the number is. So yes, it definitely looks like advantage BJP at this point of time.
Ma'am, you know, Shivamji, honestly, this all started because of the infighting of Congress, but how the things have panned out now, especially after Mr. Sindhya joining the BJP, it has sent a very strong message to his camp and the other MLAs. And there are always people in every party who are fence hedgers. They wait at the right point of time to see where the winds are aligning. So they might see today that the winds are aligning in the favor of BJP, and in due course of time, they might strengthen their position towards BJP. I would just say today, it looks like an advantage to BJP, but nothing is done in politics. It's like a T20, nothing can be sold to the last ball, but it looks an advantage to BJP. So though BJP did not do anything in a bipolar politics, when the things flow from one pole, they go to the other pole. This is a natural process which happened, and BJP was kind of, you know, BJP happens to be the gainer in this case. And especially Mr. Sindhya moving is the catalyst. He is the catalyst. He is the reinforcer of the thought process.
Yeah, can I make a point?
Yes, Joita, come in there. That's the video, and you can see those rebel MLAs as part of the resort politics that Karnataka seems to be really now infamous for. Joita, then
a lot will also depend on, you know, when the floor test is asked for, you know. I mean, I'm certain the speaker will be giving the Kamal Nath about 7 days or something, and I'm pretty certain BJP will then go to court, because the president is already there and the court has already been saying, you know, 24 hours. Remember what happened in Maharashtra? That's what happened in Karnataka. In 24 hours, less than 24 hours,
If that is the case, then I think Kamal Nath's government is in trouble, because the big, longer the time you give, what happens is that it gets easier to, let's say, you know, bring people back to your camp. So I think that possibly BJP
will
take that.
In fact, you know, let's remind our viewers that Yedurappa, the first time he tried to do that, he actually got 14 days was the time that was given, and that was long enough for MLAs to go back and forth, and his government, remember, lasted 2 days that time.
Yeah, so he because had 14 you see, the court intervened.
Yes, the court had given a 14-day period, and that's how
Maharashtra 24 hours.
Yeah. Okay, Manish wants to
like
come
that
in,
that
and we can in fact let's listen in 10 seconds of what the MLA is saying. Yes, and then we get in Manish 10 seconds of what the lawmaker is saying.
आप सबको मालूम है आज के राजनीतिक प्रदर्शन में हमने श्रीमंत सिंधिया का साथ क्यों चुना था। बड़ा स्पष्ट है कि श्रीमंत सिंधिया जी ग्वालियर चंबल और इस पूरे प्रदेश के विकास के लिए हर उस गरीब की आवाज बने, हर गरीब के संकट के समय
बिहाइंड ज्योतिरादित्य सिंधिया। यस मनीष,
I just want to add, and what Joyta was saying, and this is what I have been saying, that the fair, dignified treatment given to Jyotiraditya Scindia by the party within hour of his joining is a clear message to these rebel MLAs.
Correct.
That look, this will happen to your leader, this has happened to a leader, and more is supposed to come, because the things are already on the way, and people are talking about whether he will get a cabinet berth or whatever, because
okay.
he will be given a national role. So this will send a big message.
Okay.
Already BJP is not in that much of trouble, but BJP is trying to ensure everything that these MLAs, rebel MLAs, also get a message across that what is in store for them as well.
Okay, all right. Quick 10 seconds, Sumit, completely out of time.
I think, you know, this today I've been very quiet when Mr. Atiqul Rahman was talking about Hindutva, which I usually am not. Sir, Hindutva is a way of life,
so
which
sorry,
is...
Okay, sorry, Sumit. You know, I'm sorry. You know, I said that's a debate that we're going to leave it for another day.
Which is that by the Supreme Court of India.
No, sorry. I reined in the other panelists. I'm not going to let you have a complete walkover there. So, as things stand right now, it looks like it's advantage BJP, some of those rebel MLAs, seven more of them have come out and pledged their support to Scindia. You heard one of them saying they throw their weight behind Jyotiraditya Scindia. Does it mean that 17 out of those 22 MLAs are now solidly behind Scindia? And will that mean that Shivraj Singh Chauhan will be able to once again come back and Kamal Nath's government will not be able to win the trust war? As I said, leave it for another day. Developments happening thick and fast in Madhya Pradesh. And we at NewsX will keep you at the forefront of all that's happening there. Thanks so much for watching.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel. Hit the bell icon.